here watching that crazy man on the TV, but I called to tell you I'm still in Houston. You know I came here for the funeral last week. Yeah, Shad, they act like they don't want to bring me home. Now they're asking me to cook a gumbo. I'm ready to go to my house. You know they can't cook nothing around here. I never ate since I left my house. Now they want me to cook a gumbo so sick. But guess what? They don't have nothing I need to cook it. And they damn sure don't have my red candom there. That's what I said to myself. Can you believe that, Shad? I told my nephew I'm not cooking nothing without my red can. He said they got a store down the road called H-E-B or something like that. I said, well, you better go get it. You better go get what I need. Yeah. He said they got the red can over there. I said, man, why you ain't got it in your cabinet if they got it in the store? Because if I don't have it, they ain't going to eat no gumbo today, you hear me? But I will for sure cook me one when I get back home. I'm ready to go, me. I've been hungry ever since I came. I didn't even eat the repast food shack. Looked like the chicken was still alive, you hear me? But he said he gonna go get some, and when he gonna go be on his way to bring me home, I'm gonna make him stop that so I can grab me a can or two, you know? You want me to grab you some? Oh, don't worry about that, Sha, I got it. Huh? The name of the store is H-E-B in Houston, Texas, Sha. Yeah. Man, I'm gonna call you when I'm on my way home, because you know that highway make me nervous, so keep your phone on, okay? Okay, and I'm gonna call you when I'm on my way back. Okay. All right. Bye-bye. Want me to cook a gumbo? They don't have nothing. Look the cabinet. Look the cabinet. Dry like oatmeal. If you don't go get my red can, I'm not cooking nothing. Bring me